香港的裁判法官法例就说要求有五年的执业经验就可以做裁判法官了，但是五年是不是就代表他那个裁判法官那个水准就一定能够达标呢？以我所观察到呢，有不少的裁判官呢，纵使有五年、六年、七年甚至乎八年的执业经验，但是在这段执业期间呢，他们所接到真正落手落脚来做的案件呢，其实就不多的，经验呢就不足。当他们遇到一些比较上资深的律师的时间，他们自己对自己都缺乏信心，所以他们的质素都仍然是未达标的。香港对于司法改革是一个禁忌来的，很多法律圈和法官就很不想提及这个议题。
那美国的法官又是怎样接受监察的呢？
在2017年美国总统指派了 Peterson 做法官，但是这位 Peterson 在一个确认任命委员会那里就接受那些议员的提讯，当然是考下他对于法律的常识，就问到他口哑哑的，我们或者去片看看。
I'd like to begin by thanking President Trump for nominating me.
Have any of you not tried a case to verdict in a courtroom, Mr. Peterson? Have you ever tried a jury trial?
I have not.
Civil?
No.
Criminal?
No.
Bench?
No.
State or federal court?
I have not.
Okay. Have you ever taken a deposition?
I was involved in taking depositions when I was associate at Wiley Ryan when I first came out of law school. But that was...
Have you ever... How many depositions?
I would... I'd be struggling to remember.
Less than 10?
Yes.
Less than 5?
Probably somewhere in that range.
Have you ever tried taking a deposition by yourself?
I believe no.
Well, as a trial judge, you're obviously going to have witnesses.
Yes.
Can you tell me what the Daubert standard is?
Senator Kennedy, I don't have that readily at my disposal.
Do you know what a motion in limine is?
I would probably not be able to give you a good definition right here at the table.
Do you know what the Younger abstention doctrine is?
I've heard of it, but I, again...
That, How about the Pullman abstention doctrine?
I heard...
正话嗰位 Peterson 呢，其实在美国呢，在1999年就已经开始执业的了，直至到2017年，你看看他那个对法律的认识呢，似乎不是很达标哦。
美国那个情况呢就这样的，联邦和最高法院的法官是由现任的总统提名，经过参议院核实然后委任的，但有其他 60% 法官呢经过人民选举制度而选出来的，他们是受到这个选民的监察。最近呢其实都有声音呢是要求呢是增加最高法院法官任命这个名额，这些种种呢都是显示到呢美国的法官呢是有受到呢监察，还有这个制度呢其实是可以改的，
起码行出一步，这个议题呢是可以讨论，而且呢是应该进行改善的。